It's beer o'clock on Real Ale Craft Beer. Another day, another blade keg. This time we're going to be showing you Amstel on the blade. If I move this out of the way, you can see the blade. Oh, there's the blade machine by there, ready to go. What I want to do first is just talk to you a little bit about this keg. Because I understand there's a little bit of hoo-ha about this keg. Now, if you've got a Krups the Subcompact, which is a very, very similar machine, then Amstel is 5% ABV on the top, on an Amstel top, on the Krups, or in the bottle is 5%. Here, it's 4.1% ABV. I'll just show you. And it's caused a bit of a hoo-ha because, of course, this is 8 litres of supposed to be premium beer, but we're getting the British brewed version. Amstel at 4.1% is the British brewed version. The 5% European version, of course, is from the Netherlands. So anyway, that bit out of the way, what I might do, load this now, give it a quick review, come back with a separate video of, if I can get hold of a Krups keg, that is, get an Amstel of 5% and try and work out the difference between the two beers. But I'm going to show you how to load this keg now. So what we're going to do, first of all, take your dome off. I've done this before when I've had this in my hands, I've done everything I wanted to do, and I haven't taken the dome off the machine. And that's the first thing you need to do. Right, so spin the keg over. You're only touching the orange bits on the keg, so take the protective piece off the nozzle. Then you're pushing down hard on this button, like so. Grab hold of your keg, pull this flap down on the line, and then you've got an orange track there. Again, you're only touching the orange bits on the keg and the machine. So load your keg in, making sure not to trap your line. Push that down like so. Click it into position. Put the tap back on. Put your dome on. And then you lock your machine. There we go. I can raise this up a bit now. Now we've loaded the keg. So what you've got very quickly is two lovely bars on this machine. You've got temperature and you've got how much beer is in the keg. Two gauges, I should say. And they remind me of the little mini, the old fashioned mini gauges, which is why I love this machine as much as I do. You've also got a light. Flick the light on if you want, but we're going to crack on now and pour a beer. So what you want to do, pull some beer through your line. So you've got a line full of beer. That will give your first pour the chance, because you've just picked up the keg, you just span it over, clicking buttons in, put it into the machine. You're going to kind of shake the beer up a little bit. So you can either drink it, as I do, or chuck it away. Another thing I want to say before quickly pouring the beer is I always pre-chill my kegs. I got a little bar fridge down here in my bar. I chuck the keg in the night before, get it pre-chilled. You're not going to put too much pressure on your cooling system. So, right, let's pour. Let's pour a beer. So there we have it. First pour. Never going to be perfect. It's the first pour. I like to take these videos now with one shot. I'd rather just do it all in one shot, just to show you the real kind of machine that we have here. Nothing's edited, nothing's kind of played around with the video. It's all shot in one take. Give that an hour or two to settle down. You'll be pouring yourselves perfect pints. It's a proper quality machine. I think the Amstel keg was £30 as well, which is not too bad. So beer in the glass, then we've got a three finger white head, which is dissipating quite quickly already. The beer is nice and cold. I pre-chilled it in my fridge, as I mentioned earlier. Slow moving carbonation, light, very pale coloured lager aroma. Lemony from the hops, spicy, peppery. Let's dive in. Cheers. We're at the very end of our UK heat wave, July 2021. I'm actually going to be posting this video over the weekend. Might be today, actually. I might get it done this morning for the weekend. But it's been a scorcher. We've had temperatures in the UK of 31 degrees. And I couldn't think. I just love lagers on this machine. Just love the different lagers I've got on the machine. People are saying it's UK brewed Amstel, so it's not going to be the best. It's very difficult for me to comment on the two different beers because I haven't had a 5% Amstel probably in years. So I'm not going to be able to tell you the European version versus the British version. But what I will do, as I mentioned earlier, I will look to get a torp for this machine here, the little Krups the Subcompact torp of Amstel. And we'll go up against, we'll see what the 5% version on the Krups is like versus the Amstel beer we got at 4.1 on the blade. Bit of a slight confusion because they're both owned by Heineken. The Krups machine is heavily invested with Heineken. The blade machine is a Heineken machine. So why didn't they just have the 5% beer on both machines? It's caused a little bit of a hoo-ha. There's a little bit of kind of stuff going on social media about the 4.1%, how disappointed people are with the 4.1% ABV Amstel. It's not a terrible beer in any way, means or form. It's cold, it's wet, it's carbonated, it's hoppy, it's like lemon flavours, a lot of nice crisp malts coming through I'm picking up. It's spicy and peppery, it's ultimately drinkable. I'm going to enjoy it over this really warm weekend. But we will come back. We will come back with a comparison video if I can find a keg. If I can find a keg. But it's... I don't think it's as bad as people have been making out, to be honest. I'm certainly going to enjoy a few pints of this today. I don't know where it is brewed in the UK, but I do know it's UK brewed Amstel. So maybe you guys can comment in the comments box. Where does this Amstel keg come from? Where in the UK is it brewed, should I say? And maybe if you've had the Krups or the Blade version, maybe you can comment to tell us the difference. But I'm going to enjoy this today. I really am. Barbecue, like the barbecue. It's going to be 31 again today, 31 degrees. Couple of beers, barbecue, job done. I like the beer enough. I like it for ease of access. Come in, pint glass, pour it, job done. Back out in the garden. Happy days. No recycling, really. No messing about with a million cans or bottles after. You know when you have a barbecue and you're waking up in the morning, the next morning you've got cans all over the blooming place and... You haven't got none of that with this Amstel machine. You just got one keg that you recycle in the recycling. I like it. It's a 7 out of 10. 7 out of 10 from Real Ale Craft Beer. Please put your comments in the comments box. Subscribe to our daily beer and food reviews. give us a big fat thumbs up. Boom! Cheers!